In this overview, we'll show you the highlights of getting started setting up your application. Once you are ready to create your application, log on to the system where you will see the console, which allows you to create and manage applications. There are three things you can do: create a new application, upload the sample application, and import a template. Import the sample application to view the demo application, which has the dimensions, rules, data, reports, dashboards, and profit curves already defined. By setting up the sample application, you can familiarize yourself with the functionality provided by exploring the pre-built content. However, you can only have one application per pod, so you will need to delete the sample application when you are ready to build your own. After you have loaded the sample app, you can review the dashboards, pre-built reports, and pre-built rules. When you have finished reviewing the sample app, delete it so you can create your own application. Import template extracts from an on-premises installation all of the dimensions necessary to build an application in the cloud, as well as all of the HPCM artifacts. Templates migrate HPCM management ledger applications from on-premise to PCM cloud. Now that you've seen how to upload the sample application and import the template, let's create a new application. Rule dimension and balance dimension are the two system dimensions that are used to track what rule caused what data to move and the nature of the movement. We suggest you name them rule and balance. Once the new application is created, you can click on the Dimensions tab to see the two system dimensions that are created automatically. Next, you will need to add dimensions to describe your data and support your calculation and reporting needs. You will need to select the CSV text file that describes the dimension members and hierarchy in a parent-child format. It also includes dimension and member properties. You can go to Administering Profitability and Cost Management Cloud on the Help Center for more information on creating the file. Go to the Job Library to see if it went through. You can download the new dimension to view the CSV file. The file has rows containing dimension data. The first row defines the dimension and subsequent rows define the members. The property titles have to match, but the order of the columns can be changed. Once you've created all of your dimensions, you run Validate and Enable. Validate will check for dimension and hierarchy rules. You need at least one business dimension and one point of view dimension, and then the database needs to be deployed. Go to the Job Library to track progress. Once the database is built, you have dimensions, a place to build modeling artifacts, load data, and build rules. Now you need to set up a point of view. To create a point of view, select the point of view dimension member combination you want to enable and click OK. Enabling a point of view allows the user to create rules and execute calculations for that point of view. Then you can go into rules and switch to the point of view that you activated. Once you have started building the rules, you can continue to build views, reports, data integrations, and run calculations. In this overview, we showed you how to get started setting up your application. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.